Now you can start, I think.
Okay. Good afternoon, everybody. Today is December 6th, and we are going to start our third webinar of our Erasmus Plus project called Internet of Energy Education Qualification. Our topic today is holding a discussion on SMEs challenges in Industry 4.0, the Internet of Energy can solve. This webinar is almost 40 to 45 minutes, and then we have, at the end of the webinar, question and discussion, and you can write your questions or your opinion, and then we can discuss. First of all, I introduce myself. I'm a professor for international management at the University of Applied Science FHM in Germany, and also I'm doing international management and representative of this university in Iran. And also I'm professor for blue-green sustainability and cultural dimensions with engineering background. I had more than 200 seminars, speeches, conference, presentation, and workshop in several companies, events, and panels. For 20 years, I had experience in management consultant for international industrial management sector, also international project management, sustainability, sustainable mobility, energy management, and global SMEs. I had more than 50 publications, and that was something about combination of engineering and management. Also, I'm a reviewer and member of editorial board of 6 international journals. I have invented 2 theories, one of them called iSustainability Plus. I have invented in one international conference in Sweden in 2019, and the 5th wave theory. Now I'm showing you the content of this presentation. Introduction, energy management, IoT, IoE, energy management and production of consumption chain, introduction of smartness, digitalization and ubiquitous, the 5th wave, industry 4.0, combination of advanced technologies, SMEs challenges, IoE, SME challenges, 6 dimensions of industry 4.0, industry 4 readiness check, SME challenges in energy sector, digital transformation require a cultural change, and at the end, we are going to talk about the challenges and discussion and the challenges IoE can solve. You know, this project is about Internet of Energy, and Internet of Energy is a new concept and definition in the field of IoT in energy sector. And we are talking about how we can use the new technologies, the smartness in the field of energy management to manage them in productivity sector. Internet of Things. The IoT consists of physical objects which can communicate with each other via internet. The connection is made via integrated microchips which allow a unique identifier of devices in the network. An example, appropriately equipped printers can order printer cartridge automatically once the ink level reaches a critical value. This communication can be understood using the example of smart home, where several or all household devices are interconnected. The fridge independently reports used food via the smartphone, or the user can switch on heating using the tablet before he comes home. Internet of Energy production to consumption chain. The Internet of Energy, or IoE, is the implementation of Internet of Things technology into distributed energy system to optimize the efficiency of energy infrastructure and reduce wastage. It can also be extended to more minor levels, manufacturing and operation units. In this figure, you can see 6 dimensions of IoE and levels you can use IoE in different sectors, like oil and gas, grids, and renewable energy, and etc. Here I can show you a figure that was about the 5th wave, as I told you before. I have invented this theory in 2010, but because of lack of knowledge that time, I could not develop the model, but after 2017, I could develop the model. I'm going to publish a book about this theory. Nowadays, we passed the first, second, third, and fourth waves for ages. Before 1970, fossil energies and various business could affect, influence, and improve technologies, economy, IT, and IoT. But after 1970s, the technologies and IT became able to influence, change, and improve the various energies, business, and even impact our lives. In this slide, I'm talking about smartness, digitalization, and ubiquitous. IT-based economy and business make a procedure faster, more safe, with higher productivity. Artificial intelligence, machine learning, computer vision, neural networks, fuzzy logic, and etc., the other new technologies, and knowledge plus reality and virtuality make a new concept named ubiquitous. This is very famous in South Asia, but at the moment is not so interested for some Western countries because of the privacy. Advantages and disadvantages of digital business and digitalization process became a key issue of education, science, organization, and small medium-sized companies. The digital tools help you to implement your idea in reality with innovation, and also people and organizations can forecast the future of their business and market. Two technologies revolution are shaping the dawn of 21st century. The development of internet and shift towards a carbon-free global energy system. Decarbonization, decentralization, and digitalization are transforming the energy sector. These three global trends are changing the way we produce, distribute, and consume power. Today, Internet of Energy helps the managers to make the smart energy provision. The energy economy has moved on from a power economy to a data and power economy. The Internet of Things affects energy sector in all parts of the supply chain. In this webinar, some important related issues, including challenges of energy, energy management, technical and business model, the energy of or Internet of Energy or energy sector of IoT can solve, will be considered. The energy supply chain and role of participants. We have identified four key roles for utilities: generation, transmission, distribution, and retail. Smarter networks are needed to meet the challenges of balancing the security of energy supplies with the commitment to lower carbon emissions. Also, the energy economy has moved from the power economy to a data and power economy. That shows it is so important to combine the data or in IT infrastructure with the power economy. Internet of Energy, improving the energy management on energy SMEs with the help of technology IoE. Which SMEs actually owns the problem challenges of energy management. Also, can IoE deliver real energy saving for SMEs? Now, in next slide, we are going to see that. Now you know we are in Industry 4.0, and today we are in the fourth wave or age, a combination of advanced technologies. If you look at this figure, you can see we had the Industry 1.0, in 17th century, and then we moved to Industry 2.0, that was the mass production assembly line, and then we moved to Industry 3.0 in 17th century, and Alvin Toffler published a book in 1917 about the third wave, and he said now we passed the industrial revolution, we are in the post-industrial revolution, all information level. In this time we had computers, electronics, internet. And then today, something like after 2006 to 2011, we moved to Industry 4.0. And this is about cyber physical system, Internet of Things, networks, and using these technologies in different sectors, especially energy sector. And we call this IoE or IoT in energy sector. Here I show you on my model with more details. Something like 70 to 50,000 years ago, we had the first wave. That was about the agriculture revolution or agriculture age. And then in 17th century, we have started the second wave or industrial age. In this wave, in these 300 years, we had the industry 1.0 and industry 2.0. And then after 1970, we moved to the third wave or post-industrial age and industry 3.0 about the automation, computers, internet, and electronics. And then today, we are going to have the industry 4.0, cyber physical system, internet of things, network smartness, ubiquitous digitalization. And we say we are in the virtual reality, internet of things, artificial intelligence, and etc. And tomorrow, and the edge of tomorrow here, we are going to face with some new challenges. That's why we need to prepare ourselves and use these technologies. But we need to know which kind of challenges we have to usage of these technologies. IoE has a path towards sustainability. Environmental challenges are significant threats for sustainability. IoE could be a tool to struggle with these challenges and develop sustainability. IoE is also an innovative solution to gain sustainability in order to improve livability and quality of life. As you know, when we talk about sustainability, we have two different definitions. One, we say sustainability is quality of life plus livability, and another one is another model I will show you in the next slide. This model actually I made in 2019 for a conference in Sweden about the environmental sustainability and energy sector. My model called 7 PS or 7 pillars of sustainability. And in this model, we have 7 different aspects: political, social, environmental, economy, technical, cultural, and educational. And then you can see we can divide them in three different main aspects, like social, economic, and environmental. Sustainability is required to struggle with urbanization challenges in order to maintain the planet for future life. Introduction of SMEs, because in this presentation, I'm going to talk about the SME challenges in the energy sector. First of all, we need to know what is the SME definition and characteristic attributes. When we talk about SME, according to some different definition, for example, Institute for Mittelstands in Germany 2016, they say they have between 10 to 499 employees, between 10 to 50 million turnover, and the others, they say maximum 250 employees, maximum 50 million turnover. And there are also some qualitative criteria like local owner lead company, often family owned business, and etc. The most important one is thinking globally and acting regionally. Also in this slide, I'm showing you the SME challenges. We have 12 different challenges for SMEs, but for us in this presentation, we are focusing on 3 of them: digitalization and smartness, energy cost, and how you face with human resources. Secret of German SMEs. As you know, German SMEs, they are very famous and successful in the world, and we have 2 different internal and external secrets. Internal secret for the German SMEs like innovation, flexibility, SME thinks in generation, not quarters, loyal, well-trained staff or training, education, hidden champion, and regionally embedded by globally oriented. And external factors like excellent regional education, finance, well-development infrastructure, and effectiveness local administration. In next slide, I'm showing you another model I have published in my book, Global SME, about some solutions for these 12 different challenges in SMEs. But for us, important is these 3 challenges we have in our topic: digitalization, energy cost, and HR. For digitalization, we can use Internet of Things, Internet of Manufacturing, Internet of Energy, Smartness, Ubiquitous, and another theory I just told you, iSustainability Plus. For the energy cost, we have also Internet of Energy, Internet of Things, sustainable methods and advisors. And for HR, we have human resource management, human resource development, human resource competencies, project risk management, succession planning, and 3 international HR models. Now I'm going to show you which kind of IoE SME challenges we have. Lack of knowledge, security, cost, and interest of actors. because of know-how and do-how. How to solve them with human resource development plan in energy and IT sector? Vocational training is very helpful. Actually, you know, in Germany, vocational training is very, very improved. That's why more than 80% of employees at SME sector, they are from vocational training. Applied sciences, HR value in energy sector, dimensions of digitalization, train people, use more energy efficiency with IoE solution in Industry 4.0, and etc. Also, we are talking about the role of education, training, coaching. It can solve the lack of know-how and do-how. Training, vocational or a technical, applied sciences and academic education. And the last one is cultural synergy. That means the cultural factors are always important. In this slide, I'm showing you about three dimensions of digitalization. IT infrastructure, value chain, and management human resources innovation. I already showed you another plan about the successful consider the following tools impact your energy usage. Mobile collaboration, smart building, smart grids, and smart meters. Initial situation. Information on strategic and investment status in SMEs in the field of digitalization and Industry 4.0 is mostly based on self-assessment. The nationwide SME 4.0 Competences Center offers training workshops and information. The SME Digitalization Index, KTI, provides an empirical basis of the current state of digitalization and its dynamics. The Digitalization Index is designed as a cockpit instrument for entrepreneurial monitoring in company ranking and investment decisions, also for the structural policy decisions and economic development. In this slide, I'm telling you who are the IoE actors in energy management sectors. We focus on SMEs like universities, HR management companies, digitalization companies, or IoT companies, and etc. In this figure, I'm telling you how we can make our companies smart, especially in the energy sector. We have two parts. In the left side, you can see the power of digital sector, and in the right side, IoT innovation for manufacturing SMEs and Industry 4.0 in energy sector. You have here big data, IoT, IoE, IOB, IOM, phonetic, high performance computing, bioinformatics, cloud, 5G, ubiquitous robotics, and etc. And on the right side, we have digital innovation centers, leadership through platforms, smart regulation in industries and business, integration of national innovative business ideas, cultural infrastructure inter to the digital area, and ICT standards. Okay, now we are talking about SME challenges through IoE. Optimizing the usage of smartness in SMEs is very important. For this, we need to find the HR chain actors. Reliability also is very important because we want to have tools, technologies, for example, IoT, artificial intelligence, machine learning, IoE, in Industry 4.0 for energy sector to capture more data and control them. You remember, in my first slide, I told you, we are moving from the power economy to the power and data economy. That's why data is so important. But the second step after machines is people, because people, they need to analyze this data to control the devices to be not out of the standard conditions. For this, we need to find the kind of competencies in SMEs, HR, IoE technologies, and infrastructure to provide the required data for these human resources. In this human resource, we need to have some experts to do innovation, implementation, development, and apply these IoE technologies to make the SMEs smart. Also using the energy with high efficiency. SMEs HR competencies, they are very important. For this, we need to have roadmap that show what kind of people and competencies we need to have in our SMEs for this kind of smart technologies like IoE. The cultural factors and HR competencies are most important challenges in using smart IoE technologies in near future, as I told you in the fifth wave model or theory. That is why it is important to make this IoE technology simple and user-friendly for HR and public sector to face with them for tomorrow. We need to motivate them and also show them the benefit. In next slide, I'm showing you how we can do that. Here you can see the six dimensions of the basis of Industry 4.0. Although Industry 4.0 can bring significant benefits and development to the Internet of Energy and help relevant decision makers make better and more effective decisions. This approach requires simulation, preparation, and development in several dimensions. Now I'm going to talk about these dimensions. If you look, the first dimension is a strategy and business model. We need to have clear transparency strategy and business model to show the people and SMEs the benefit. Also, we need to use the technologies, big data, cloud, and all in technologies that are relevant to the digitalization and Internet of Energy. And also finance and risk management, because the financial benefit is the most important motivation for people and SMEs to use this kind of technologies. Also, they need to forecast the risk to do risk mitigation. Next one is the network and services, and then the system process. And the last one is employees and their competencies, and also cultural factors. Here also we have another slide about the Industry 4.0 readiness check that shows which kind of level we have for the competencies of human resources and the actors inside the SMEs energy sector. Now in this slide, I'm talking about the SMEs challenges in energy sectors. We categorize them in two big groups, energy challenges and energy management challenges. Energy challenges. Increasing the energy consumption, waste energy, human society and cultural factors of how to use energy. We need, for example, to teach our children or next generation how they need to save energy for the future. Completion of fossil energy, fossil fuel and tendency to renewable energy. Environmental changes, tendency to network information systems, rising the energy cost and technology development. The second group is energy management challenges, energy managerial challenges, energy technical challenges, and business model challenges. In next slide, I'm going to talk about more detailed information. IoE can be a solution for energy management challenges, but how? Ensure the efficient building data management system, reduce energy consumption by identifying suitable IoE, improve uptime and reliability of industrial utilities, regulation or regulatory complaints of production environment, development of awareness of water, air, gas, electric, and steam, wages, usage, move towards sustainable development and environmental protection and IoE solution for new policy, waste as energy. Train people to use energy more efficiently and IoE solution. Some of the challenges the IoE can solve in the SME sectors. Soaring global demand of clean energy, centralized grids are no longer adequate, smarter grids ensure a more reliable supply, dealing with mountains of data, AI and quantum computing are transforming the energy sector. But how? Number one. Rapid population growth makes the challenges in supplying energy in future. In addition, energy based on fossil fuel make environmental problems like climate change by greenhouse gas emissions. And the solution to this dilemma is to generate power from renewable energy sources in a way that climate natural is possible. The second one, as energy system is growing more complex, the old centralized grid could not be kept up with. New and modern stabilized grid are required. The third one, to manage a more complex energy system, it is needed to make power grids smarter. Sorry. Internet of Energy through digitalization and innovation could make smarter grids. Further, digitalization also can increase the competitiveness and usage of renewable energy to deal with environmental problem and challenges. Number four, or increasingly complex decentralized energy landscape is generating huge volume of data. To be kept up with this data, IoE could be a solution. For instance, in 2003, about 500 million devices were connected to the internet. Further, connected devices will jump to more than 20.4 billion from 8.4 billion in 2017. And today, we are going to have something like 25 billion, and that shows we are dealing with so many complex challenges. And the last one, artificial intelligence in the form of machine algorithms and quantum computing as another groundbreaking technology are introduced as new technologies. And they are all based on the fifth theory. These new technologies could shift the world towards sustainability through utilizing cleaner energy. And in next slide, I'm a little bit talking about this one. Here, I'm talking about challenges to make the SME smart in energy sector. There are seven challenges, according to my model, 7 PS, seven pillars of sustainability. Social challenges. This is regarding to cultural, education, people, human resource, and their competencies. Economy, finance, money. This is also a very important point. Technology. Which kind of technology we want to use? For example, Internet of Things in energy sector, IoE. Political aspect is also important. For example, some regulation, some policy, some strategies. Environmental. You know, we always thinking about how we can use this IoE to make the usage of energy efficiency and effectiveness. Also with the looking at blue-green sustainability and environmental factor or environmental friendly. Cultural factors are so important because if we don't have a good infrastructure culturally, then we cannot train the people in the right way. And education, vocational training, and cultural synergy. Here I'm talking about advantages and disadvantages. For example, advantages. To make the SME in energy sector smart. To prevent crimes. To make transparency. Control the mobility, energy management, with higher efficiency and effectiveness. Improve the training in the field of energy or IoE faster, easier, and more attractive. Disadvantage, privacy, culture, missing human factors, because we need to be more flexible, maybe this smartness make us a little bit less. Financial matter and fraud risk. I'm going to conclude my presentation in two slides. The legal administration or administrative and financial procedure should be established to facilitate planning and application of renewable energy projects. The need to move towards a sustainable energy future by wider use of renewable energy would be a big challenge for the energy management. High productivity, high sustainability, low CO2 emission, or low greenhouse gas emission. These challenges have huge and direct impacts on the operation and control of power systems. Now, I conclude some other stuff about management and digitalization. Innovation is necessary. Future is based off information, new technology and knowledge. Re-engineering the procedures of various businesses is also necessary. Differences in size of company are significant. Companies with 250 and more employees, particularly these companies with less than 200 employees, little digitalized. The value chain has the biggest potential for digitalization. This is time lag between technical possibility and the practical application. The benefits of digitalization are not yet seen in large number of SMEs. Opportunities must be created for the further training and qualification of employees regarding to digitalization in energy sector. Okay, what is the future scenario? Here in this slide, you will see the future research suggestion. Recognition of energy resources, alternatives, ways of replacing renewable energy sources, defining the domain affected by the implementation of intelligent energy management system, presenting of model for the implementation of Internet of Energy technology or Internet technology of energy, understanding of the infrastructure for Internet technology implementation, Internet of Things, introducing ways to use wireless sensors network in industrial environments, and finally, the options for future energy system compatible with sustainable development include more efficient use of energy and energy-intensive materials, integrated use of renewable sources of energy, more efficient production and use of fossil fuels, fuel substitution from high carbon to low carbon or no carbon-based fuel. In my two last slides, I'm going to show you some models to solve these challenges. In this slide, you see a model to how to make one startup or SME innovative, smart, and digital. You can see we have the idea in the core of this model, and then you have the innovation in marketing, business, and technology, and then you have the 7 PS factors: environment, economy, politic, technique, education, social, and culture. And at the end, you have the DID or digital index dimensions, IT infrastructure, management, human resources, innovation, and value chain. And then at the right side of this slide, you have another model for sustainable, innovative, smart, inclusive SMEs. We need to do these steps. Number one, SME acceleration program, knowledge platform, access to financial services, capacity building and knowledge transfer, promotion of entrepreneurship and inclusive in business, and the last one, innovative and technology upgrade process. In this slide, we have the model or theory, as I told you, iSustainability Plus. This theory is doing the combination between innovation, sustainability, and digitalization in energy sector. You have the 7 PS in the core: politic, social, environment, economy, technique, culture, education, and then you have the ubiquitous reality, virtual reality, high tech, IT infrastructure, and smartness. And at the end, you have the innovation, business innovation, technology innovation, and marketing. And I'm going to show you the last slide, photo of this slide. It is about smart SMEs or SME in energy sector in Industry 4.0 called SME 4.0. For a smart system, we have front-end system, back-end system. For business system, we have business strategy, business motivation. For manufacturing system, we have mass production system, customization system. For process system, we have progress process selection system, operations plan system. For product system, we have financial, functional oriented system and building oriented system. And the last one, marketing system, technology and marketing. Thank you so much for your attention, and I hope I could talk about my topic in 30 minutes okay, and you could understand the topic. But if you have any question, we have something like 5 to 10 minutes to discuss about the presentation, then you can write your question here, and then I will answer you and we discuss together. Thank you, and I wish you a good afternoon. You are welcome, everybody. Thank you too for your attention and attending to the webinar. Okay, I can see one question about an example of IoE. As I told you at the first of the presentation, IoE is a new project about using the IoT in energy sector. I'm going to the first part of the presentation. And the main point in IoE has, you can see here, the energy economy has moved from power economy to the data and power economy. That means we are combining the digitalization and IT infrastructure